The answer is the second choice. If it were possible to compute discrete logs quickly, and our adversary had a way to do that, well, then they could compute the discrete log of the intercepted value YA, the G and the Q values, which were also intercepted. Those ones were public. And the result of this would be the XA value that was Alice's secret. And then the adversary can compute the key the same way that Alice would. This was the only secret value. And if you had the discrete log function, you could compute that secret value. The second answer doesn't compute the right thing. It's computing the discrete log of YB, which would be the YA value. That's not the value that is necessary to compute the key. The third value doesn't use discrete log. If we could actually compute the key this way, well, then the protocol would be completely insecure because it turns out that modular exponentiation is a function that we can compute efficiently. And it's necessary that we can compute modular exponentiation efficiently because otherwise the legitimate participants in the protocol wouldn't be able to determine their keys. So we'll look at that soon. Before doing that, I want to emphasize that this is not a proof that breaking discrete log is hard.